Good to be back with you. St. Vincent and the Grenadines will get to you in a shorty short. But first, I want to start with Barbados. Stabbings at schools in Barbados is becoming a worrying thing for the government and for parents. But I will say to you that parents will have to take grave responsibility for some of the things that are happening with children in school. Let me go to the article first, and then we will discuss some of these things. For the second time this week, and this was recently, a student at the secondary school had been stabbed in a fight, prompting education leaders to implore parents to step up and do more to prevent the spread of violence. Barbados Today has learned that two students were involved in an after-school altercation at the back gate of the Great Ormond City Secondary School, resulting in one of them being stabbed. The ages of the students and the weapons used were not immediately revealed. In a statement in the evening, the Ministry of Education confirmed that the injury was not life-threatening, but expressed concern about how a different outcome could have impacted families, friends, staff, and the student body. The incident followed the stabbing at the Alexandria School in the second week of the term, in which a 15-year-old boy was injured. The development prompted the ministry to make a special appeal to all education partners for greater vigilance, particularly urging parents to take action. Now, yes, the government has a role to play in terms of providing security for students and teachers. They have a duty as well to ensure that students, when they come to school, that they're not carrying weapons in their bags. If these bags are not checked at home, it is the responsibility of the ministry to get enough security in place, proper things in place, to scan bags or to have bags checked manually. That is going to be an arduous task, but it has to be done if the situation is ongoing, like this is becoming untenable. In terms of parents, they're saying that they're urging the parents to take action. So it means, therefore, that they're telling the parents, look, before your child comes to school, check the bag. See what they're doing. Know who their friends are. The problem is now that it appears that a lot of the parents, based on discussions that they're having, are saying that the parents hardly pay attention to children who are in Form 3, 4, 5, and so on. They may pay more attention to Form 1, Form 2 students, but those 3, 4, and 5, this is according to the discussion that they're having, to see what is in their bags when they're leaving home. So it is becoming a problem. But some of the parents have abdicated their responsibility towards their children, and that is half of the problem as well. So the parents will have to take blame. Some of them don't even know what is happening with their children. We have another problem where students or children have become parents. Some parents have allowed their children to simply take over the household. So as we used to have back in the day, parent dealing with children, now children are telling parents what they want to do. And this is apparently some of the issues that they are bringing to the fore with this situation. So they don't know what is going on. They are not searching the bags. They're not asking them questions. And so they're coming to school with knives and the likes. So the parents will have to pay greater vigilance in terms of what is happening there. Then you have children making children who can hardly take care of themselves. And these children are going to school as well. So a young lady may drop out of school, 17, 16. She ends up with a child, and the child is now going to school. She can hardly take care of herself, yet she has to go and take care of a child, discipline the child, instill morals, instill values, whatever you want to call it, in that child. She doesn't have the app to do that. So then there's a problem. That's another problem that they're facing. And that is part of why we are having all these things happening in these secondary schools and primary schools too. It is a big problem across the Caribbean, but it places a burden now on the school system to get proper security to deal with these children when they come to school. And what is going to happen? A lot of parents are going to be saying, look, you're taking away my child's right. You're infringing on certain things. You're searching up in his back for what? You will have some parents like that, although a situation is taking place which warrants searches. But there's a great deal of responsibility that has to be placed on the parent, and a failure on the part of the parent in that regard. And the quicker we put a handle on it, the better it's going to be for all of us. We don't want any more incidents like these. We don't want children dying in school when they should be learning in school. So that's the issue over there in Barbados with the children there at school. Now we turn our attention to the issue of St. Vincent. And over the years, we've had some kind of killings. And the school of thought in St. Vincent and the Grenadines right now is that children are possibly being sacrificed for something. What is it? We don't know. But that is the school of thought in some of the shops, some of the bars, people expressing concern on the street. If we go back to this first story in February, it says a 22-year-old male suspect of Rosal has been apprehended and is assisting the police with the investigation into an infanticide homicide occurred at about 7 p.m. on Saturday, 10th February in Rosal. And it says preliminary investigations reveal that the suspect stole a one-year-old infant from a home and slashed her throat. The infant's body was later discovered about 51 yards away from a home and pronounced deceased by the medical practitioner. The suspect is a close relative of the deceased. Now, when you listen to this, where you're stealing a one-year-old infant from home and slashing her throat, that is not a normal thing. It's just simply not normal. It's demonic, very diabolical. And that is why people are questioning whether or not the children are being sacrificed. By whom and for what? So we're going on to another story. So we'll follow this. We will follow this, right? Recently, the Royal St. Vincent and the Grenadines Police Force has launched a homicide investigation following the discovery of a 13-year-old boy. His name is Matthew D'Souza of Fair Hall. His body was found on the beach at Sandhill on Monday, September 30th. Preliminary reports indicate that D'Souza's body was discovered naked from the waist down with apparent injuries to the head. But of course, they're going to do a post-mortem examination to determine what caused his death. One person is currently assisting the police with inquiries as the investigation is ongoing. Now, what we've been hearing is that an 11-year-old girl is assisting the police with that investigation. There was a release put out by the police first, which they recalled, which said a number of minors were helping the police with the investigation. That was recalled, and then it was sent out to say one person is helping the police, and then we understood it to be that an 11-year-old girl was assisting the police with the investigation. Now tell me, 11-year-old assisting the police with the investigation in the death of a 13-year-old who apparently had wounds to his head and found half naked from the waist down. If this is not some sacrifice again, tell me what it is. It is diabolical. It has to be that something is going on with the children in St. Vincent and the Grenadines. 11-year-old is among the suspects based on what the police is saying. But this is really, really diabolical. And this has to be demonic in any form you take it. And then we had another disturbing one where we would have seen an 11-year-old boy. But the police had said, were providing an update in the investigation, an 11-year-old boy from Vermont whose body was discovered on August 20th. And a post-mortem examination was conducted. And the finding determined that the cause of death was due to hanging. And at this stage, there is no evidence to suggest foul play. That is what the police said in their report. We heard from a lot of people in the community, and they were talking about the child playing a TikTok game with some other family member or friend. And then he went outside, and when he didn't return, and when they went to look for him, they found him hanging. Another demonic story. Another diabolical situation. And that is why persons are asking the question as to what is going on. But who is doing the sacrifices? We will never know. That's the question people are asking. And then you had another strange death where the police in St. Vincent launched an investigation into the circumstances surrounding the death of a 10-year-old female student. Preliminary investigations had revealed that around midday on Saturday, this is early this month, police in Calico Police Station, they received a call and they went to the family home of four persons. Discovered in the house, one in distress, and one of them appeared to have been dead. The police immediately responded to the report and visited the scene. On arrival at the scene, the police discovered four females, one adult, three minors in the house. Three of them were lying on a bed, one on the ground. On close examination, three of them were breathing and a 10-year-old appeared motionless. They were saying that there was a possible gas leak in the house. That was some of the first stories emanating. And then they're saying, secondly, it doesn't look normal. Then we heard about no foul play suspected in that. But the whole point about it, these deaths are simply strange deaths among our children, young children. And that is why the discussion is an ongoing discussion as to whether or not they're being sacrificed. The question is, by whom and for what? That is going to be an ongoing discussion. But the way these children are being taken out, it's a strange, strange occurrence. And these are young children. When you talk about a one-year-old infant being stolen from a house, throat slash, that has to be demonic. And we will continue to talk about that in a further video, so look out for that. But I just want to encourage the students over there, the parents in Barbados, you have a duty to fulfill to your students. And this situation in St. Vincent, where these young children are being taken out like that, is something that we have to continue to pay attention to. All right? Thanks a lot for watching.